光在变迁，爱童成少年，纯真的笑脸，善良又勇敢，回头才发现生活是那样甜。原来幸福就在眼前，抬头就能看见蓝天，因为有梦而变得不凡，属于你我的明天。
I'm a travel vlogger with 30,000 followers. How could you possibly think a small village is a good choice for me?
Come on! It's not just any small village. I've heard that Huayu. You know, the food vlogger with more than 3 million followers. He's going there to make a video too.
You mean the arrogant and narcissistic vlogger who uses his pretty face to attract silly girl followers? That Huayu?
Anyway, there must be something special with this village. Why else would he travel such a long way to get there?
Fine, I'll go make the video there. Wait, what's the name of the village again?
Xiajiang Village. The village we're going to is called Xiajiang Village. It seems somebody didn't do her homework.
And who are you?
I'm the arrogant and narcissistic vlogger who uses his pretty face to attract silly girl followers. Huayu.
Oh, what a coincidence. Nice to meet you.
Catch. Instead of bad-mouthing other vloggers, don't you have a lot of work to catch up on?
Located deep in the mountains of western Zhejiang province, Xiajiang Village was once a place known far and wide for its poverty. In recent decades, has the meeting place for six secretaries of the CCP Zhejiang Provincial Committee. Xiajiang Village has undergone radical changes under the care of the CCP Central Committee, led by the General Secretary.
What's going on? The little one has just been back for 2 days. What did he do this time?
I don't know what's wrong with him. He said that my methane tank was out of date, and he's gonna give it a refresh. So he started painting on the cover and made a real mess of the whole thing. He would have removed the guardrails if I hadn't caught him in time.
It is old, strained, and ugly. What's wrong with my change?
Shut it! How dare you talk back to Grandpa!
It is the truth.
But if you mess up and destroy the original, there'll be nothing memorable left of it.
What's so memorable about a silly cover?
What did you say?
All right. Calm down, brother. It'll be fine. How about this? You let me take him for a bit and show him around the village.
Fine. I'll leave him to you. Maybe he can learn something after all.
Dad! Grandpa! You guys head back! I'll stick with Granduncle!
Hey, Mr. Secretary. Another tour again?
Yeah. And today, I have a little helper with me.
Listen carefully to Mr. Secretary, little boy. He has been the party branch secretary of Xiajiang Village for nearly 30 years. He has received 6 provincial party secretaries who came to do research here. He's a real star guide.
Xiajiang, there's another pack of tourists at the village entrance. Are they waiting for you?
Yeah, I'm on my way there now.
You have quite a busy schedule ahead of you.
Granduncle, I didn't know you were such a famous tour guide.
Nah, not really. I just like to tell the story of Xiajiang Village and welcome visitors to our humble town.
I see.
Wow, I've never seen this kind of bird before.
Is it okay to wander around the village before we meet our guide?
What do you mean? Are you worried I'm going to collect some good footage before you?
Don't overthink it. I specialize in food vlogging. There's no competition between us, unless I want to cook those birds.
Granduncle, I don't understand. What's so special about the methane tank? My grandpa values it so much.
Hongxing, what do you think of the view from here?
I'd never get to see many huge trees or clean rivers in the city.
But did you know that the trees along the mountain were almost all cut down before?
Then, did you and Grandpa do something to protect them?
Your grandpa used to cut down trees in exchange for food.
No way! Grandpa loved trees more than he loved me. When I was a kid, I bumped into a small tree and fell to the ground. Instead of picking me up, he walked right to the tail of the tree first. How could such a grandpa cut down the tree?
It's okay if you don't believe me. After all, it was a long time ago. Not even your father was born by then.
Oh, I wasn't born yet. But wait a minute, Granduncle, you still haven't answered my question yet. Why don't you want to answer it? What does that have to do with the methane tank?
Why don't you ask your grandpa directly about it?
Nothing special. Boring.
Hey, Hongxin, watch out!
Hongxin and Miss, are you both all right?
I'm fine. Hey, kid, are you all right?
I'm fine.
Oh, that's great. I was so focused on shooting. Oh, my camera!
Huh? What happened to them?
Brother, your grandson bumped into Miss Lee and they fell into the river together. Miss Lee just so happens to be the girl who booked your bed and breakfast while she's visiting. So, I brought her over here to introduce her to you. What a coincidence.
What an unfortunate coincidence indeed. My camera and clothes are soaked, and now I can't record. Why am I so unlucky?
Don't be so sad, miss. Go take a shower and change out of your wet clothes, or you'll catch a cold. Wang Hai, go get some clean clothes for her.
Oh, all right. Don't worry, Miss Lee. I'll ask my wife to bring you some clothes.
You little troublemaker!
All right, brother. I need to go receive the tourist group at the village entrance. Hongxin's one-day tour will need to be put off until tomorrow.
All right. You go ahead.
Are those markings your work? Kid, are you hesitating now to go up and apologize?
No, I won't apologize. I didn't do anything wrong. By the way, I'm not a kid. My name's Jiang Hongxiu.
Oh, Jiang Hongxin, you have quite the personality. So, what are you still doing here?
I'm just wondering why my grandpa and dad valued my think tank so much.
Well, kid, ask if you want to know.
I said my name's Jiang Hongxiu. I'm not a silly or some little kid.